I invite you to stand. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name, amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty Father, whose dear Son, on the night before he suffered, instituted the sacrament of his body and blood, mercifully grant that we may receive it thankfully in remembrance of Jesus Christ our Lord, who in these holy mysteries gives us a pledge of eternal life, and who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Those here I invite to have a seat as we ponder the words of Go to Dark Gethsemane, and those at home, we invite you to sing out loud.
I invite you to join me in reading. The first reading is from the book of Exodus, the 12th chapter. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat of it. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you to join me in reading the appointed portions of Psalm 116. I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication, because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I called upon him. How shall I repay the Lord for all the good things he has done for me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his servants. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds. I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem. The second reading is from 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. I receive from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
I invite you to stand for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet and put on his robe and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor the messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. This is a night when we usually wash feet, a symbolic action representing our desire, our intent, our calling to serve one another. In doing this, we reenact what we heard Jesus do for his disciples in John's gospel. He washed their feet, and then he commanded them to love one another, just as he loved them. The word Maundy, in fact, is derived from the Latin word meaning commandment. In essence, you could say that today is all about love. And that is why we are not washing one another's feet this evening, just as we didn't administer ashes on Ash Wednesday, and we don't receive wine with communion, why we wear masks, and why we continue to maintain distance from one another even as we get vaccinated. It is out of love and in service to our neighbor during this time of pandemic. But in thinking about this, not washing feet this year gives us a chance to reflect on this story a little differently this night. When we wash feet, our focus quickly shifts to service and care for one another, which is important, necessary, and good, because too often that's not our natural inclination. But this evening, I invite us to place our focus and reflection on what Jesus is doing in the Gospels as he approaches his death. This is the Last Supper that Jesus is sharing with his disciples before his arrest and the fast track to his crucifixion. In the other three Gospels, Jesus and the disciples were gathered for the Passover meal, the annual remembrance of God's faithfulness recounted in the first reading that we heard Sim read this evening, when God heard the cries of the people and delivered them from oppressive slavery in Egypt. This time, however, it's not just the annual recitation of the Passover story. At table with his disciples, Jesus said to them the now familiar words of institution that we hear each Sunday. As Jesus took bread, "This is my body given for you." And as Jesus took wine, "This is the new covenant in my blood shed for you." All through Jesus' ministry, he was giving of himself, and now he knew that soon he would give his very life for us. That is God in the person of Jesus taking sin, suffering, even rejection upon himself for the sake of God's creation. That kind of self-sacrifice is a stunning revelation about the extraordinary nature of God, about the depth of God's mercy and faithfulness. Then in John's gospel, Jesus gets up from the meal, takes off his outer robe, ties a towel around himself, pours water into a basin, and stoops to wash the feet of his disciples. Another stunning revelation about the extraordinary nature of God. Washing feet was dirty business, but it wasn't unusual in that time. Not like where I grew up in the North. Where I grew up, people wear shoes and socks or nylons. It's both not easy to wash feet when you have to go to such trouble to get your shoes and stockings off, and more to the point, feet in shoes and stockings tend to stink. Well, it's a little embarrassing. The church service would be unattended if people knew they had to take off their shoes and stockings. So washing feet on Maundy Thursday was left to a few volunteers who were asked in advance and had prepared for the role. It was a spectator event for most. But back in Jesus' day, that wasn't a problem, as most people wore sandals. But when you wear sandals and your mode of transportation is mostly walking, your feet get dirty, as we all know. In Jesus' day, it was a sign of hospitality to have your feet washed when you arrived as a guest at someone's home, but it would be a servant who would tend to you, not the person of honor at the meal. It's no wonder that Peter was so appalled at the idea of Jesus washing his feet. But then that was exactly Jesus' point. He was demonstrating for his disciples and for all of us exactly what it means to be a servant to one another, and it starts from the top. No one is better than another. We are all loved and blessed as God's creation. That was radically different than the way the world functioned in Jesus' time, and it's still pretty radical today when we consider not what we say, but the way we act. But then Jesus' action got even more stunning, for Jesus knew that the feet he washed that night included Peter, who would deny him, and his disciples, who would disappear in fear at the time of his most grievous hour. And he knew that he would also wash the feet of Judas, who would leave that meal to betray him. Even as Jesus knew that, we are told that he loved them to the end, and he washed the feet of every one of them. We know the challenge this places before us in how we treat others. Jesus had said, "Love your enemies," and this was Jesus living those words. And not just living them, it was Jesus loving his disciples, all of them, to the end. We are living in harsh times when it is so tempting to write people off if they hold opinions different from our own, or if they see things differently than we do, and certainly if they've done things we vehemently oppose or that appalls us. It is most certainly true that this action on the part of Jesus challenges us, and we would do well to meditate on that. But this year, I encourage you to consider what this action on the part of Jesus, on the part of God, means for you personally. God does not write any of us off. God continues to love us to the end, and God continues to tend to us, washing our feet, even when the shadows are lurking. This evening or tomorrow or whenever you next take a bath or a shower, wash your feet and think about Jesus doing that action tenderly, lovingly. Jesus stooping to tend to you. Jesus loving you to the end. And after you really sit with that, after you have given time to reflect deeply upon that, then you can get up and consider how you can wash the feet of others. Amen. I invite you to stand for the prayers. With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord. For Michael, our presiding bishop, Bob, our bishop, for all ministers and church staff, and for all of us in our ministry, let us pray to the Lord. For our president, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord. For this city of Honolulu and throughout these islands, for affordable housing, health care, and quality education, let us pray to the Lord. For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord. For the aged and infirm, for the widowed and orphans, and for the sick and suffering, let us pray to the Lord. For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for prisoners and captives, and for all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord. For deliverance from all danger, violence, and oppression and degradation, let us pray to the Lord. That we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach, let us pray to the Lord. In the communion of St. Peter and of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. We pray to you, O God, in the name of the one who endured the cross, forgives our sins, and feeds us at his table, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I invite you to be seated and enjoy a music interlude while I wash my hands in preparation for the Eucharist. I invite you to stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins, he was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself. And by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious God, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we'd fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and maker of all. Jesus stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread. And when he'd given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine. And when he'd given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, Almighty God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling Christ's death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in Christ. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. At the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our Savior. By Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. I invite you to be seated. I will come to you, and if you wish to receive, place out your palm. I will place a wafer in your palm. We ask that you hold on to those until I return, and then we will all partake together. Thank you. the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. I invite you to join me in the post-communion prayer printed on page 10. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of Christ and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now send us out to do the work you've given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. We will now silently strip the altar. You may remain and meditate and be here as long as you would like. The service continues tomorrow at 11:30. Again, you may stay as long as you would like to.